partial sums and convergence of a series. You can read this part right here. The partial sums are capital S sub n, and we'll talk about what those are. And if they limit out to a number of capital S, so that as n goes to infinity, the partial sums converge to S, then the series converges, and it converges to that S. So you can write the series sum equals S. If Sn does not exist by way of either going to infinity or flip-flopping back and forth, something like that, then we say the series diverges. So here's an example. Here's a sequence. 1, 1 half, 1 fourth, 1 eighth, continuing in that pattern. So the sequence is the list of numbers. The series is the sum of all the sequence terms from the first one to infinity. And that just is denoted this way. So it'd be the sum of all these sequence terms on to infinity. So it's an infinite sum. A partial sum is a sum of the first n terms of the sequence. So it's a finite sum. You stop at a sub n. And that's why, you know, I had to write this with the I counter instead of the n, because the n is the last one. And that's called capital S sub n. That's a partial sum. So then other notation is that if this number, the limit as the partial sums of n goes to infinity equals S, then since those partial sums are equal to these, and with the limit, so the S sub n, each one of those is equal to the sum, stopping at n, it's a partial sum, and you take the limit as n goes to infinity of those, that's what is meant by having an infinity up here. That's what that means. Okay, so if that partial sum exists, then the series converges and converges to the limit. So here's your example. The sequence terms are a list of terms. The partial sums, S sub 1, is the sum of the first one. Well, the first one is just 1, so that's 1. S2 is the sum of the first two. 1 plus 1 half, which is 3 halves. S3 is the sum of the first 3, like this, and that adds up to 7 fourths, and the sum of the first 4 terms equals all this, equals 15 eighths. Now, one method to figure out the series sum is to figure out the partial sum pattern. In other words, what is the nth partial sum? So you take these numbers and you say, well, in the numerator it's 1, 3, 7, 15. So I wrote those down here. 1, 3, 7, 15. I know there's some kind of power of 2 going on in here. So I analyze the differences. 3 minus 1 is 2, 7 minus 3 is 4, 15 minus 7 is 8. So sure enough, there's a power of 2 pattern from one of the numerator values to the next. So I take a stab at it, and I just say, okay, well, I think the numerator numbers are 2 to the n. Okay, well, that's not right, because 2 to the 1 is 2, not 1. But what if I subtracted 1? Because look at 1 is 2 minus 1, 3 is 4 minus 1, 7 is 8 minus 1, 15 is 16 minus 1. So then I have this numerator pattern. So what you're doing is you're guessing, adjusting it, and then checking it to make sure all the numbers work. Now we're going to go for the denominator pattern. That's 1, 2, 4, and 8. So those are direct powers of 2. So I would say 2 to the n. But for n equals 1, 2 to the first is 2, not 1. So I'm off by 1, so I must either go n plus 1 or n minus 1. So we go n minus 1. So that n is 1, 2 to the 0 is equal to 1, check. So this is working. So this is your partial nth sum. And we just want to find the limit as n goes to infinity. So I thought of breaking it up in a fraction, dividing the denominator into both of the numerators with a subtraction sign in there. 2 to the n divided by 2 to the n minus 1. That'd be like 2 to the 4th over 2 to the 3rd is 2. Or 2 to the 7th over 2 to the 6th is 2. So this just automatically cancels out to 2. There's no limiting going on there. Then on this one, n goes to infinity. This denominator goes to infinity. 1 over infinity goes to 0. So there the limit is in effect. And that's it's equal to 2. So all those numbers in the sequence add up to 2. So the partial sums go to 2 as n goes to infinity. Hence the series, which is the limit of the partial sums, goes to 2. We can check that because this particular sequence happens to be a geometric sequence. So they're not always geometric, but this one is. It takes on this form here. When you say, notice that's geometric, you can put it into this form. Some constant number out in the front. So that's the first term. That's 1. The ratio that's being hit on each term to get to the next one is 1/2. And so you have 1/2 to the n minus 1 is your sequence terms form. And then we saw previously in another section that geometric series added up to this quantity here. So a is 1 and r is 1/2. So when you take the limit as n goes to infinity, you're going to have 1/2 to the n is 0. So it's 1 minus 0 over 1 minus 1/2, which is 2. So that checks out.